will have a talk by Aleksander Zawada, and he runs, I hope I pronounced it correctly, Prywatna WytwÃ³rnia Lamp.
Almost correct.
Okay. And he will show us how to do your own vacuum tubes.
Thank you for inviting. My laboratory is in Warsaw. I am a worker in Tele and Radio Research Institute and Nuclear Research Institute. I have two quarters of my laboratory. One is in my terrible house without windows and doors. The second is in my job in Tele and Radio Research Institute. When I leave last flat, I asked my boss if I can przenieść, move my laboratory to my job. He told yes, of course. Why private tube manufacturer? After the Second War of World, Professor Wiesław Barwicz started National Radio Tube Factory in Dzierżoniów. In Germany, it's Reichenbach im Eulengebirge, after destroyed Telefunken factory. Wiesław Barwicz died in 2002, and he was the first director of Industrial Institute of Electronics. Today it's my job, Tele and Radio Research Institute. About National Tube Factory, it was moved to the Warsaw city in 1948. The name was changed to ZWLE, and it collapsed in 1993. And completely destroyed in 2011. Why? Yes, it collapsed because electron tubes shouldn't. We haven't sell it a lot of. Why I started? Because I think that it's a good idea to care historical technologies. A lot of this is forgotten. I think that it should alive. At these pictures, you have old products with National Tube Factory. What can I do? I'm interested in vacuum technique and electron tubes technology. I try to make electron tubes, ion tubes, Geiger counter tubes, a lot of another, other devices, and vacuum meters. A lot of equipment I try to prepare myself. It's rather easy in Poland because we can't to buy a lot of by eBay, but Poland is very strange country. In the institutes or at, in the schools, there is a lot of kilometers, tungsten wires, tantalum plates, and pumps and other devices, and if you know when and where, you can have everything, but it's almost as Nikita Khrushchev funeral. Quickly, quickly, silent, you know, I know, and enough. That's why I use trashes, because it's very important to be before trashmans. Sometimes in institutes, it's cleaning, and if you know when, you must be before, and you can be before trash months. Some words about basic equipment. It's needed torches, ultrasonic cleaner, induction heater, glass vertical lathe, pumping units, vacuum furnace, some chemicals. Since November, I have also horizontal glass lathe and machine for glass metal wafers. What is a glass metal wafer? It's part of electron tube. It's a vacuum-tight glass metal connector. Usually I use soda glass with metal called phenicuma. Thermal coefficient of expansion is identically for glass and for this alloy. Since November, I can do better glass wafers because I can add vacuum pumping pipe to the glass wafer. It's in the right picture. Okay, now I am going to tell something about making triode. It's rather easy case, but for a good example. Okay, starting. The first is calculating. I calculate lifetime because I can use a higher diameter of tungsten wire to cathode, but power consumption is higher. I can use smaller diameter, but then lifetime is shorter. And it's compromise between lifetime and emission current and power consumption. And the second is painting construction picture with dimensions of all parts. And the next is making main details. Anode, tungsten cathode, molybdenum grid, glass wafer, getters, sometimes insulators. It's glass drop with connected with wires. About making grid, I use point welder. Maybe it would be better to say spot welder. One of the electrodes is a copper template, and welding wire, molybdenum wire with nickel wire, you have a grid. The next is connecting all parts using power welder, point welder. And the next process is washing electrodes and another welded parts in ultrasonic cleaner. I use two times per. It's another to say tetrachloroethylene. The next two times in ethyl alcohol. And the next is drying by dry air. In the next operation is connecting glass wafer with a glass balloon. I use vertical glass lathe. During this operation, glass wafer with electrodes and glass shield spinning together synchronically and heating by a torch, I start melting glass. And at the moment, it connect. The next operation, I need to remove glass stress inside glass connector, because if I remove interruptly, this connector could be broken. During the process of removing glass truss, the temperature is lower and lower. I need a lot of time because it's minimum 1 hour. And when glass is cold, I can connect tube with pumping unit. It's necessary to do high vacuum inside tube. The ultimate pressure should be less than 5 multiplied 10 to the power minus 6 torr. I use oil diffusion pump on rotary pump, sometimes turbo molecular and ion getter pump. During pumping, it's necessary to do the next process, it's outgassing. If not, after pumping, vacuum will be bad because outgassing of electrodes. Outgassing process could be done by three ways. The second is by electron bombardment. The second is by torch. And the third is induction heating. It's recommended to recording parameters during this process because sometimes should be something should be bad, and it's a good idea to test what was wrong. After pumping and disconnecting tube from pumping unit is flushing getter process. During this process is running chemical reaction between barium aluminium alloy and nickel powder. The result is nickel aluminium alloy and free barium as getter. Barium can include with oxygen or nitrogen and another gases, and vacuum is better. At the right picture, you have three glass pipes with flushed getter during the process, but in the first was another pressure. At the left, the pressure was 10 to the power minus 2 torr, and you see that getter is smaller than another pipes, and it's darker. It's recommended to flush getter if you have very good vacuum. Finally, process. Glass part of tube is connected with metal ceramic socket called Jumbo. For example, for Jumbo, it could be another connector. For sticking, I use glyptal glue, mixed with zinc oxide, calcium carbonate, and acetone. Okay, done. Making triode is rather, with tungsten cathode is rather easy. Worst if we need a tube with oxide cathode, because it's a lot of work. Something about it. I start by cutting nickel tungsten tape or wire alloy called NEW5 because it contained 5% tungsten and rest is nickel. The next process is washing, similar as I told before, but the next step is washing tapes is boiling these tapes in pure demineralized water, because chloride without tetrachloroethylene, just only 0.05% pollution by chloride on the cathode could be the reason of poisoning and you can't have electron emission from this cathode. The next stage is drying of cathode, so on dry air. And the next process is preparing emission paste. About ingredients, it's butyl acetate, barium, strontium, calcium carbonates, and nitrocellulose. The best carbonates contains 4% calcium carbonate, 37% strontium carbonate, and 59 barium carbonate. Its weight proportion. I prepared carbonates myself using nitrate solutions and sodium bicarbonate solution. During reaction, you have, as a result, you have mixed carbonates, barium, strontium, and calcium. The next, I have to paint wires or tapes. My paint is emission paste, but I must to do very quickly because butyl acetate become dry very quickly. The vapor pressure of this substance is very high. Finally, cathode is ready. It could be used for electron tubes, but one advice. But during pumping, it's necessary heating cathode and controlling pressure. It couldn't be worse than 10 to the power minus 4 torr during heating because of destroy cathode risk. Similar technology could be used for yttrium oxide cathodes. The properties of these cathodes is such that you can working in the air and in the vacuum, and there isn't no risk poisoning the cathode by oxygen. Having oxide cathode, it's possible to do a lot of electron tubes. For example, magic eye tube. In the old radio receivers, it was used as a signal detector, a signal indicator, maybe it will be better to say. About luminescence material, I used zinc sulfate activated by silver. It's blue shining. Yttrium oxide activated by europium. And zinc sulfide, sulfate activated by copper and aluminum. Similar technology can be used to preparing luminescence screens for X-ray detection. You have a red screen during X-ray capacitor and integrated circuit. Down is the picture of X-ray ion tube prepared myself. Ion tube is something else about ion tubes. Ion tubes contains gases inside glass shield that sometimes it isn't necessary to pump it very well. It's possible, sometimes it's possible swelling or maybe to better tell washing tubes by gas, by filling gases. For example, you have a discharge tube with metal flower mounted by phosphor or Maltese cross tube. Okay, having a glass wafer with a lot of metal connectors, and if you have electronic parts, for example, resistors and capacitors, prisoning in the prisoned in the glass. It's possible to do something similar to do to integrated circuit. Few times ago, in the German was manufactured a tube called 3NF. It's my version of this tube. You have almost completely radio receiver inside, without tuning coil, without capacitor tuning, without headphones, of course, and without potentiometer to regulating volume. I wonder if it's possible to scale down this integrated circuit. I think that it's possible, but it's a new problem. How to do high vacuum inside? Because każdy kolejny. The next part inside, it could be source of gases. That's why I try to do miniature ion pumps and ion gauges to measure the pressure inside micro volumes. I started from rather big dimensions, doing small, smaller, and the smallest. The smallest pump has length as half a mesh. Ion getter pump needs a magnet for working. That's why I constructed a small magnet with magnetic field 0.65 Tesla between poles. The weight is rather high because it's 30 gram. About vacuum measurement in inside small volume. I tried to do small miniature Bayard-Alpert gauges. There is hot cathode, tungsten cathode emitted emitting electrons, and electrons during collision with molecular gases then create ions, and measuring ion current, I can measure vacuum inside. Another construction with plate electrodes. It's smallest than Bayard-Alpert gauges, but jak to będzie zasada działania? Zasada działania. Rule of working is identically, almost identically as Bayard-Alpert gauge. In this, okay, in this picture you have zależny wykres, jaki jest wykres, jaki jest zależność albo wykres. At this picture you have collector current value and pressure value. Yes, at this diagram, yes, I forgot. About parameters. If the pressure is 10 to the power minus 3, ion current is maybe 3, 4 microamps. For Bayard-Alpert gauge, for the smallest gauge, it's below 1 microamp, but it's a very good result because it's rather high sensitivity compared to volume. In traditional Bayard Alper gauges, you have a volume circa 200 centimeters and sensitivity is circa 20 millibars or hectopascals to the power minus one. In my miniature gauges, where the volume is below one cubic centimeter, sensitivity is maybe four, maybe three millibars to the power minus one. There is a miniature vacuum system. The volume is half cubic centimeter, and you have graph pressure versus time. I started with three multiplied 10 to the power minus 3 millibar, and the end is circa 2 multiplied 10 to the power minus 4 millibar. It doesn't matter. Maybe about pumping speed. It isn't very big, very high. It's only 2 cubic millimeters per second, and later 0.7 cubic centimeter as at this graph. Some words about electron beam welding. You are believed that usually to this process is need high vacuum, better than to the power minus four torr, but it isn't always necessary. I tried to do primitive tube. You have spherical cathode, thin molybdenum foil, and during bombardment by electrons, it's heating. The same cathodes was used in the first X-ray tubes, and the pressure in these tubes is circa 10 to the power minus 3 torr, sometimes higher, sometimes lower. But if you have a strong power supply and optimal pressure in the chamber, it's possible welding a lot of materials. For example, copper, nickel, iron. You needn't high vacuum and complicated electron gun. I built simple electron beam welder. It contains a rotary pump, a vacuum chamber with viewport. It's prepared from old vacuum valve, and a viewport is prepared from old glass, from old glasses. There is a vacuum valve between a pump and chamber also, vacuum leak valve, valve between atmosphere and chamber. One vacuum tight connector for high voltage supply and primitive vacuum meter. At this picture you have a welding process. About power supply, it was transformer from microwave plus rectifying diode. Cold cathode was from tin of beer bottom, and it was in the first version, but during process this cathode melted inside, and that's why in the next experiments I used a better cathode with aluminium. During welding I dose a little of neon or argon, eventually mixture. At this picture, you have a sample before welding and during welding. And it's really end of my presentation. I have a short video. I would like to special thanks to my boss, Dr. Piotr Konarski from Tele and Radio Research Institute, and to my friend Żyraf, a very clever mechanist who can help me. If you want to contact with me, you can use this email address. And we have some minutes. Okay, may I start this video, yes? Okay, there is a vacuum meter. The pressure is circa 10 to the power minus 2. This video was prepared maybe 26 December, and I haven't a lot of time to prepare this. You have a vacuum chamber. Inside is small light bulb. I disconnected it. And at the moment, I start, I connect high voltage. Okay, it started. And the next, I will dose a little of neon to the chamber. Please wait, yes. Okay, I started. And the next is starting welding. There will be a very hot spot. Oh, it's visible now. And at the moment, it will be the end of process. Okay, it's the end. I have some samples after electron beam welding in my bag. If you want to say it, it will be possible. Może po tym, maybe during break, yes. Okay, thank you.
Dziękuję bardzo.
Dziękuję.
So this was again a very impressive talk, and the comments in the RSC, you should have seen them. One was like, you should show this at an art gallery, the small devices you built. And yes, really impressive. We have some more announcements. One will be Mitch in a minute, because he will have his solar workshop, but it's not only for kids, it's for all ages, and he will tell this again. So, what else? We are still want your enlistment in the social event list. So, when you want to get dinner with us, go to the cash desk. There is a list prepared. And Mitch, please come on.